Formula E is full electric. Futuristic noise.
Quelque chose de neuf est excitant.
10 teams, 20 drivers, 10 races, 5 continents, one new championship, Formula E. It's a revolution in the history of motorsports. For the first time, single-seater cars powered by a fully electric motor will be competing around the world.
Estamos con Lucas y Graci. So Lucas, can you tell me what's the difference between racing an electric car versus a regular car?
Well, I think the first thing you can say is that you don't put any emissions in the air. No, the real thing about Formula E is that it's no different from any other motorsport. You have a car, you have a motor, you have 10 teams, 20 high quality drivers, and we race like any other sport. The difference is I think the main difference is how the race develops. With the battery, you have to manage the energy, so the strategy is much more important. But that's pretty much the only thing you have to learn when you come to Formula E. The rest is the same technique as a combustion car.
And I also heard that the vehicles are all the same. They're made by the same company. So now it depends more on the drivers. Is that true?
That's correct. All the drivers, they have the same same possibility to run the same equipment. That does not mean that there is no difference team to team. Yes, there are differences between teams, between setups, tire pressure, ride height of the car, springs. You can change a lot of stuff, but essentially the cars are the same.
So this is a little bit more of a personal question. How did you become interested in racing?
I was just pure by luck. I was racing go-karts. I was young. With my older cousins, my nothing special, and then I start to have good results, and one thing led to another, and when I was 21, I became a pro, and since then, yeah, Formula One and so many other stuff. I'm probably in the best moment of my career, doing 2 championships for Audi Sport, so it's really, really good.
Congratulations. So I'm interested in positive psychology and how people overcome challenges. And my question is, how do you deal with losses?
Loss is a very broad term, but in a way, the way I do it, I don't really care about the result, I care about my performance. So what I focus is to get everything right all the time, everything that is under my control. If something happened that's outside my control, that's not really what I can do about it, even if the result's not there. So it's what happened to us. The last 2 races, we had a poor result, but because of a mechanical failure. It was not my fault, it was not team's fault. So you don't need to be upset about it, you just need to keep working the same way as you were working before, work even harder, making sure that you mitigate all these risks and go for the next event.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for talking with me, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much.
From 0 to 60 miles an hour in less than 3 seconds, a top speed of 140 miles an hour, a one-day event consisting of a 60-minute practice session, a qualifying session over 2 timed laps, and finally, the race, during which drivers must make a compulsory pit stop in order to change cars. It's a unique format to which the Formula E drivers will have to adapt.
The electric car has a lot of torque. So for a driver technique, you have to be very gentle on throttle and then how it behaves on wheel spin and controlling that. And also this car, for racing aspects, you need to be very efficient. So that means you have to drive as fast as you can, but trying to consume the least batteries possible.
The project was developed over many months in collaboration with some of the top motorsports companies. One of them, Spark Racing Technology, was commissioned to build 40 single-seater cars. Joining them in this innovative project were Dallara, McLaren and Williams. But one of the key players was France's Renault Group, a technical partner well known for its experience and expertise. Renault worked closely with Spark and the FIA to develop the Formula E concept, as well as a new racing car, the Spark Renault 01. Because electric vehicles live or die by their battery life, and that was one of the team's greatest challenges.
The glycerin fuel that we use to power Formula E cars is so clean that you can actually drink it, as my team and myself will demonstrate today.
Nice.
Delicious. Wow, it's really thick.
It's like licorice.